Without getting into specifics of what you've declared for the quarter gone by, let's understand how will life look for SBI once the moratorium gets lifted?
So one is that even during this COVID period, I'm talking about first about the operational part. I will come to the credit quality and other things later on. So we have operated at full capacity. All our branches, 98% operational, excepting wherever some local issues are there. All our internet banking, mobile banking, ATMs. So all of them have performed than what they were doing pre-COVID-19. So that speaks volumes about the quality, determination, and courage of the people who work in State Bank of India. So that is part one. And if you have such a committed workforce, then whatever is the situation, we are capable of facing it. So if we can face it in operations, we will be able to face it as far as all our asset quality is concerned, our earnings is concerned, our business growth is concerned. So today, we have very strong processes. We have high quality committed manpower. We have the best-in-class IT, digital, and analytical capabilities. And this is what makes the organization. And the challenges keep on coming. But if you are a resilient organization like State Bank is, so we will be able to overcome any challenge which comes.
When we spoke last, I sincerely expressed my gratitude for the kind of service State Bank of India has done. Not even one person has come to us on social media or on Twitter and said, "Look, my ATM was not working, or there's a problem with my banking issue." So what looked impossible when the lockdown was announced, State Bank of India has made it look very easy. So my compliments clearly on that.
Thank you.
Specifically, let's talk about your understanding of how things have opened post the lockdown has started getting lifted. Do you think the economy, the demand, everything is coming back as per your expectations, or there have been pocket of surprises also?
One is that it all depends upon in which sector of the economy you are, right? So some of the sectors were very severely impacted and they remain impacted. So for example, hotel, tourism, aviation. So these are the sectors which are most severely impacted and they will take considerable time before things get normalized. But other sectors like, say, power. So power demand, I am told that it is almost come back to the normal or pre-COVID situation. There was a drop, but it has come back. Steel, the demand went down to, or the, sorry, the production went down to 25-30% of the capacity. It has come back to 75-80% capacity. Automobile yet to start seeing a good pickup. Still, things are happening and it may take some time. Same can go for the demand in the housing sector. So it all depends upon sector to sector. But things have started coming back to the normal. And ultimately, from the supply side, the constraint not maybe as many, but when the outlets or where the consumer demand happens, when these start operating, and second is that consumer sentiment also that should change and needs to change. That change will happen when people, the fear of virus goes out of their mind. So it is a combination of factors. And because we were in a strict lockdown condition, so it will take 1 or 2 months, and then we will have a better idea. But demand is coming back, and the supply side also, the supply chains are being restored.
Do you expect that the credit culture in India could change because of this moratorium? What was called as a discipline stroke, CIBIL stroke, normal non-unsecured lending, at least at the retail level, because of moratorium, there could be challenges there.
No, it is not about India. So let us first understand it that this moratorium, where there is a disruption of the cash flow, whether it is individual or businesses. In such circumstances, globally, in all regulators and the regulators who are also supposed to be as tough as our Reserve Bank of India, whether it is US, whether it is Singapore, whether it is European regulators, everywhere realizing the situation, some dispensations have been given. So credit culture would be impacted by this moratorium. I don't subscribe to that view. It is a realization of the ground reality. And it is a realization of the fact that people want to pay. But if there is a disruption to their cash flow, which is not in their hands. So in such circumstances, it is logical that repayment is always aligned to your capacity to pay. And this is a realignment to their capacity to pay. It is not about intent. That is how I view it. And I don't think that this is going to impact the culture. The people who don't pay, they don't pay, whether COVID or no COVID. And the people who want to pay, they are paying even in COVID. And the statistics is with us. We are 82% of our customers. Where we have said moratorium is available, but they have paid more than 2 installments. So what I feel that we should not, at least I don't subscribe to this theory. And this is not a phenomena which is peculiar to something India has done exceptional. In fact, if you ask me, our regulatory guidelines as on date are much tighter than what they are in other countries.
So on that part of moratorium, I know you've been asked this question at the press conference also, but that is of immense curiosity. You have a fantastic number there. Less than 20% of your total borrowers right now have opted for moratorium. For that, for State Bank of India, which is lending across categories, across the board, that number is a very smart number. That clearly tells us that you have a very strong retail book. Can I safely conclude that?
Yes, that is what we have always said. So numbers only prove that. But in an earlier quarterly earnings call or whenever I had a chance to talk to analysts or people like you, I have always said that our business segment is different. And the difference is that we cater largely to the one, the employed. And employed by whom? By the governments, by the, you know, well-known corporate. So the impact on these employees is much less, and that's why this performance.
One last question, which is of everyone's interest, is why are you raising capital when all the ratios are favorable for you? You're in a golden spot, sir, which is that your CASA has gone higher, NBFCs are finding it difficult to lend, your balance sheet is strong, your reach is strong, and yet you're raising capital.
I'm not raising capital. No, bond issue is our regular MTN progress. So that is just a bold resolution. So we are not doing anything exceptional or raising capital. That is, we have a running MTN program, and where we keep on raising the money, paying the money, but that is all for our overseas operations. We are not raising any capital, and we don't intend to as of now, because I believe that we have sufficient levers. And we have sufficient cushion in our earnings, subsidiaries, our loss asset and D3 accounts where we have 100% provided. So that's why, like, we have an enabling resolution of raising 20,000 crore. But I doubt that we are going to use it in near future.
So one final question. Every shareholder of State Bank of India, when I meet them, they said, "Is hamara din kab aayega?" So when do you think that time for SBI shareholders will come back?
Market is such a thing that whatever you do, but you can't find the market, right? They find reason to go down. I sincerely believe that market has not been fair to State Bank for whatever reason. But it, as I said, that it is ultimately the choice of the investors. But if you look at our performance, nobody has been able to fault us on our performance quarter after quarter. But despite that, and this I made an observation in one of analyst meet, that somebody sneezes and people feel that State Bank will get flu. But that's not the case. So can't help it. But the fact of the matter is that if you look at our balance sheet today and the size of the balance sheet and the earnings, there is no reason that our stock should have gone down in value so much.